Today we have quite interesting math challenge. We need to find all numbers from 0 to 20 using only 3 threes and these following math operators or symbols. So you can only use these symbols and nothing else is allowed. Alright guys, some of these numbers are very easy to find and some of them are a little bit harder to find. But overall, it's an interesting one. But before you guys start with this one, I would like to define some basic rules. So, as I mentioned earlier, you are only allowed to use these following operators or symbols. So, you can use the decimal point, but just to be clear, you can only use 0.3. No other decimal value is available to you for this challenge, so only 0.3. You can use addition operation in any form that you like, also subtraction you can use in any form that you like, and multiplication, of course, you can also use in any form. You can use fractions as well, so 3 over 3 or quantity of 3 minus 3 over 0.3 or anything else that you like is available to you. You can use an exclamation point, which in mathematics stands for factorial or subfactorial functions, so both of them are available, and you can use equal sign. Nothing else can be used for this challenge. And to be even more clear, I will show you what is not allowed. So you're not allowed to combine two or more numbers. For example, you cannot combine two number threes to get 33 or 3.3 or 0.33 or anything else in that matter. Also, you cannot use powers or roots, so you cannot use 3 to the power of 3 or square root of 3 or cube root of 3. You cannot insert any new number or add more numbers to the problem, so you cannot add another number 3 or any other number in that way. Also, it is not allowed to use any other math operation or function, so trigonometry, logarithms or anything else is not allowed. And this one is really important, you cannot use any type of brackets for this challenge. So brackets are not allowed. Also, the not equal sign is not allowed. This would be cheating, guys, so we're not going to do that. And programming languages and functions are also not allowed in this challenge. Okay, so now since we established all the ground rules, I will first use this minute or two as a quick reminder for factorial and subfactorial functions, because I found out that a lot of people actually don't know these functions. So in mathematics, factorial is marked as exclamation point in front of the natural number. And we define factorial as the product of all positive integers less than or equal to a given positive integer. So, for example, 6 factorial will be equal to 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is, in this case, equal to 720. And, for us, the more interesting one is 3 factorial, and that is equal to 3 times 2 times 1, and that is equal to 6. Of course, you're going to remember this value, because we're going to use this one in our challenge. Next, we are going to take a look at subfactorial. We can write subfactorial as exclamation point in front of the natural number. And it is defined as the number of ways a group of objects can be arranged so that none of the objects is in its original or correct place. Another way to call subfactorials is a number of dearrangements. To be more clear about this, let's look at the following table. So let's first start with number 1. This means that we only have one object. So it is not possible for us to arrange one object in any other way. That means that subfactorial of 1 is equal to 0, since there are no dearrangements for this one. Next, let's say that we have two objects, 1 and 2. For two objects, we have one possible derangement. So we can arrange them as 2 and 1, and in this way they will not be in their original places. So that means that subfactorial of 2 is equal to 1, and finally the one that is most interesting to us is 3 objects, or number 3. So what do you think, how many derangements we have for 3 objects? Well, the answer is 2. We can arrange them as 2, 3, 1 or 3, 1, 2. Just a quick reminder, you cannot arrange it as 3, 2, 1 because 2 would be in its original position. So that means that subfactorial of 3 is equal to 2, and this value is the one that we are most interested in this particular challenge. Of course, if you want to find subfactorial of any number, you can use this formula, or you can use a little less complicated formula, that subfactorial of n is equal to the floor function of n factorial over e, where e stands for Euler's number that we can approximate to 2.718. Okay, so now we have everything that we need in order to solve this challenge. And as I mentioned earlier, there are really tons of ways to solve this challenge. And I will encourage you guys right now to pause the video and to try to solve each of these numbers for yourself and then come back to see the solution. Alright, let's get to the solution. So, I will show you one or two ways at most for each individual puzzle. I will not show you all possible solutions because this video would be like 3 or 4 hours long. I will leave that to you guys. So, if you find another way to solve any of these puzzles, please write it down in a comment section. Alright, so first I will do all single digit numbers from 0 to 9. I will start with the easiest one and then we will gradually go to the harder ones. Okay, so the easiest one to solve is how to get number 9 out of 3 threes. So this is pretty straightforward. It's 3 plus 3 plus 3 that is equal to 9. So this one was by far the easiest one. Okay, so next one is how to get number 3 out of 3 threes. This one is also straightforward to solve. It's 3 plus 3 minus 3. And that's it. I really cannot think of easier way to do this one. Okay, the next one is to find number 6 out of 3 threes. This one is also easy. So we can do this as 3 times 3 minus 3, which is 9 minus 3, and that is equal to 6. Alternatively, you can use 3 factorial plus 3 minus 3, and that would also lead you to number 6, but we're going to stay with this first easier solution. Okay, next one is to find 0 with 3 threes, and for this one, we're going to use a fraction. So we're going to say that that is 3 minus 3 over 3, which is 0 over 3, and that is equal to 0. Alternatively, you can use something like 3 factorial minus 3 minus 3, and that would also lead you to number 0. Okay, so we got that one as well. Next one, let's see how can we get number 2. Well, for number 2, we are also going to use fractions, and it is pretty easy one. It's 3 plus 3 over 3, that is equal to 2. Alternatively, you can use something like 3 minus 3 over 3, and that would also give you the value of 2. Now, for next one, we are going to see how can we get number 4 out of 3 threes. And this one is easy as well. It is 3 plus 3 over 3, that is equal to 4. And to be honest with you, I think that this is also the easiest way to find number 4. Okay, next we will try to find number 1 out of 3 threes. For this one, we will say something like 3 minus factorial 3 over 3. Just as a quick explanation, that would be equal to 3 minus 6 over 3, and that is equal to 3 minus 2, which is equal to 1. So this would be my way of solving this for number 1. Okay, the next one, let's find the number 5 with three threes. This one will be really similar to number one, and the solution is quite similar, only we use plus instead of minus. So in this case, this is 3 plus 6 over 3, which is equal to 3 plus 2, and that is equal to 5. So this is the way to find number 5. So now let's try to find number 7 with using only 3 threes. For this one, we are also going to use the factorial. So this is 3 factorial plus 3 over 3, and that would be equal to 6 plus 1, which is, of course, equal to 7. And finally, the last, but not the least, is how to find number 8 of using 3 threes. This is the most complicated one for this bunch, and you can find this one as 3 factorial plus 3 factorial over 3. Just a quick explanation, that is 6 plus 6 over 3, that is equal to 6 plus 2, and that is equal to 8. So there you go, guys. We have all our solutions from 0 to 9 with only using 3 number 3s. Okay, I hope you got the solution so far, because right now we are going to solve 2-digit numbers to number 20, so each number from 10 to 20 with only using 3 threes. Again, I will start with the easiest one, and that is number 12 in this bunch. And 12 can be found as 3 times 3 plus 3, which is equal, of course, to 9 plus 3, and that is, of course, equal to 12, and I think that is the easiest method to find this number. Next one in the line is number 15. And we can find number 15 as 3 factorial times 3 minus 3. That would be equal to 6 times 3 minus 3, which is equal to 18 minus 3, and that is, of course, equal to 15. Okay, the next one will be number 18. This one is also not that difficult to find, because it is equal to 3 factorial plus 3 factorial plus 3 factorial. That is, of course, equal to 6 plus 6 plus 6, which is equal to 18. So, as you can see with the use of factorials, this task becomes really simple. Next one, we're going to do number 11 using 3 threes. For this one, we're going to use subfactorials for first time. So my solution for this is going to be something like 3 factorial plus 3 subfactorial plus 3. That would be, of course, equal to 6 plus 2 plus 3, which in terms is equal to 11. So we are going to start to use subfactorials now. So next one will be number 16, and we can solve the number 16 as, for example, 3 factorial times 3 minus subfactorial of 3. Just as a quick explanation, that is 6 times 3 minus 2, which is equal to 18 minus 2, and that is equal to 16. So we got number 16 as well. Next one in the line is number 20. This one was difficult to sum, but to be honest with you, I don't think it's difficult at all. We can solve 20 as 3 factorial times 3 plus 3 subfactorial. As you can see, it is basically the same solution as for the 16, only we're going to use plus this time. So that is 6 times 3 plus 2, that is, of course, 18 plus 2, and that is equal to 20. Now let's go to the next number, and next number is number 10. So number 10 we can get from 3 threes as following. So 3 factorial plus subfactorial of 3 plus subfactorial of 3. Of course, this is equal to 6 plus 2 plus 2, and that is equal to 10. So we can say that this one is solved as well. Now let's see number 14. How can we solve this one? So 14 will be equal to 3 factorial plus 3 factorial plus 3 subfactorial. Of course, this is equal to 6 plus 6 plus 2, which is in terms equal to 14. Okay, so next one will be number 13. And for this number, for the first time, we will use the decimal points. we can solve number 13 as 3 over decimal point 3 plus 3. That is equal to 10 plus 3, which is equal to 13, and this is how we will get this particular number. Next number will be number 17, and we will also use decimal points for this one. We can solve this one as 3 factorial over decimal point 3 minus 3. Quick explanation, that would be 6 over decimal point 3 minus 3, which is equal to 20 minus 3, and that is, of course, equal to 17. And finally, guys, the last but not the least, how do we get number 19 using only 3 number 3s? I left this one for the last in purpose, because when I was doing the research for this video, I found a tons of ways that people got number 19 from 3 3s, and all those methods were extremely complicated. I will just show you these two examples of how people found number 19 using 3 3s. As you can see, there are floor functions up there, there are lots of brackets, there are even square roots, and all other stuff. I was really amazed to see this, because I can assure you that this is really easy to find. Let me show you. We can find 19 as 3 factorial minus decimal point 3 over decimal point 3. Believe it or not, that's it, because this would be equal to 6 minus decimal point 3 over decimal point 3, which is equal to 5.7 over point 3, which is exactly equal to 19, and that would be our solution. Okay, so we got all numbers from 10 to 20 using only 3 threes. If you guys found another way to solve any of these problems, or you have an easier way to do this, please write it down in a comment section. I really enjoy seeing all other different methods and all other different options. Of course, if you enjoyed this video, give it a like, subscribe to the channel for more math challenges in the future, it would mean a lot. And of course, as always, until next time, see you guys and take care.